In this presentation, we look at the analysis of sequential circuits. Of course, we consider sequential circuits. We take first analysis for a D flip-flop, and as we can see in this figure, there is one D flip-flop. Its output is A, and the input D consists of the following. We have two exclusive OR gates. This one here, input is A, and this is X exclusive or Y, and therefore this will be A exclusive or X exclusive or Y. That is the input D of the flip-flop. This is how we write it. Now we know from before that the relationship between the input and output of the flip-flop as follows. A at time t plus 1 is equal to D of A. Therefore, based on this, we have A of t plus 1 is equal to A exclusive or X exclusive or Y. Of course, this one is A of t. Now, analysis means we write down or derive the state table and or the state diagram. The state table is a function between the next state and the present state and the inputs. Therefore, we construct a table where we write the present state A and the inputs X and Y on the left-hand side, and then from these, we derive the next state A on the right-hand side. Now, from the relationship that we have just derived here, we notice that A of T plus 1 is the exclusive OR of A and X and Y. Therefore, all we need to do is to write down one for the combinations where we have the odd function. Either Y is 1 and the others are zeros, or X is 1 and the others are zeros, or A is 1 and the others are zeros. All of them are ones. In these four cases, A is equal to 1, and in the other cases, A will be equal to 0. And this is the state table, which is the result of the analysis of this circuit that has one D flip-flop. Also, we can write down the state diagram for the circuit. The state diagram, here we have only one flip-flop, which will have two states, either 0 or 1. This will be the state of the flip-flop. When the state is 0, we consider these four rows in the state table, where the inputs are 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. And we notice that when the inputs are 0, 0, or 1, 1, the next state will be 0. Therefore, we write here a small arrow saying for these two inputs, the next state will be the same as the present state. Whereas the other cases, when the inputs are 0, 1, or 1, 0, next state will be 1, 1. So what we do, we write an arrow here saying for these three inputs, the state will go from 0 to 1. So this finishes the first four rows of the state table. Now we come to the other four rows. Again, we notice that when the inputs are either 0, 0 or 1, 1, the state which is 1 will remain at 1. Therefore, we come here and write down this arrow here, and we say when we are in state 1 and the inputs are either 0, 0 or 1, 1, we stay in state 1. And finally, if the inputs are 0, 1 or 1, 0, we go from state 1 to state 0, and we're presented by this arrow on the state diagram. And this is the complete state diagram. Therefore, what the circuit does is the following simply. If it is in state 0 or state 1, if the two inputs are the same, which means both are zeros or both are ones, we stay in the same state. Whereas if the two inputs are different, which means 0, 1, or 1, 0, we go from one state to the other state. So these are the transitions between the two states, and this completes the analysis of this circuit. This circuit, which is with JK flip-flops. Now we have here two flip-flops. One is called A and the other is called B. And J of A is equal to B, as we can see here. And K of A is equal to B and X prime. So this is JA equal to B and K equals B X prime. Now, flip-flop B, the J is equal to X prime, we write it here, and the K is equal to A, X exclusive OR with X, and we write it here. We know from before for the JK flip-flops that the output of the flip-flop is equal to JQ prime plus K prime Q. Now, J and K are the input and the Q is the output. If we take it for the A flip-flop, we find that A of T plus 1 is equal to J of A dot A prime or K A prime dot A. Substituting J A and K A from here, we find that A at time T plus 1 is equal to this expression A prime B or A B prime or A X. And B at time T plus 1 equals again J B dot B prime or K B prime B. And again, substituting these values here, we find this expression for B of T plus 1. Now, deriving these, actually, we have derived the relationship between A at time T plus 1 here, and A and B and X, and also B at time T plus 1 in terms of A and B and X. This will enable us to state diagram. Now, the state diagram, we have here four states. We put them inside circles, 0, 0, 0, 1, and 1, 0, and 1, 1, and we look at the state table. If we are in state 0, 0, if the input is 0, we go to 0, 1. So we write this here. If we are in 0, 0, input is 0, we go to 0, 1. And if input is 1, we stay at 0, 0. So we write this one here. And if we are in state 0, 1, for input 0, we go to 1, 1. So we are in 0, 1. If input is 0, we go to 1, 1. We write this here. And input 1, we go to 1, 0. So we write this one here. Then we come to the third state, which is 1, 0. For the two inputs, 0, 1 and 1, 0, we go to 1, 1 and 1, 0 respectively. So from this state, we go to 1, 1 at input 0 and 1, 0 when input is 1. And finally, if the state is 1, 1 and input 0, we go to 0, 0. So from 1, 1, input 0, we come here. And when input is 1, we stay at 1, 1. And this completes the state diagram. If we would like to find out the flip-flop input values, which are JA, KA, JB, and KB, these are the flip-flop inputs. We derive them from the equations that we saw in the previous circuit diagram. So simply JA is equal to B as an example. So this column here is equal to this column here. So of course, when we say equal to B, B at time T, not at time T plus 1, because time T plus 1 would be after the clock pulse. So this will be, JA here will be 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, exactly these values here in this column. Same thing for KA, KA equals B and X prime. So we make ending between B and the complement of X. So B X prime means if this is 1, 0, this would be 1 here. And so on, JB equals X prime and KB equals AX exclusive or X. So we can derive the inputs of the flip-flops if needed. This is with T flip-flops. And we have a circuit with two T flip-flops. One is called A, the other is called B. And T of A equals X and B. This is X and B, and T of B is equal to X. We remember for the T flip-flop, the characteristic equation, which is the relation between Q at time T plus 1 and Q at time T is input T, X exclusive or Q, or T prime Q or T Q prime. applying this to the two T flip-flops, we have the following. We have A at time T plus 1 equals, now instead of T here, we write T of A, which is Bx. So it is Bx exclusive or A, which is Bx prime dot A or Bx dot A prime. And it is equal to this after we do this using De Morgan's, which is Bx prime is B prime or X prime and all dot A. And B at time T plus 1 equals X, X exclusive or B. Same thing exactly as we have done before. If we want to write down the state table, we write the present state and the input on the left-hand side, and then we write A here on the right-hand side, the next state, and we derive A at time T plus 1 and B at time T plus 1 using these equations up here. So let us take an example. A at time T plus 1 equals A and B prime. So A and B prime means A is 1 and B is 0. So for these two cases, we will have these here 1. And the next one, AX prime. So A is 1 and X is 0. So this is A is 1 and X is 0. And X is 0 also for this one. And we have A at time T plus 1 equal to 1. Or A prime BX. So A is 0, B is 1, and X is 1, which is this here. A is 0, B is 1, and X is 1. A at time T plus 1 equal to 1. So these four combinations, A is 1, and the others, A is 0. Same thing exactly, we derive B at time T plus 1, which is X exclusive OR between X and B. So X exclusive OR X and B, this would be 1 here, and this would be 1 here, and also this would be 1 here, and this would be 1 here. Finally, the output for the circuit is simply A and B. So the output will be 1 in the last two cases when A and B are 1s. So this is the state table. Now the state diagram is straightforward here. As we have done before, we have four states. The 0, 0, we drive 0, 0 here, and 0, 1 here, and 1, 0 here, and 1, 1 here. And here, if you notice, the output depends upon the state. So we can write the output inside the state. The output will be 0 in this state here, and this state, and this state, and it will be 1 here. And we say, when the input is 0, when the state is 0, 0 here, in the first two cases, the output will be either 0, 0, or 0, 1, depends upon x. So, if the input is 0, we stay here, and the input is 1, we go to 0, 1. Same thing for state 0, 1. If the input is 0, we stay here, and the input is 1, we go to 1, 0. Same thing, if the input is 0, we stay here. If input is 1, we go stay here. And for 1, 1, for input 0 here, and for input 1, we stay here. Actually, this can give us a very good idea about what does the circuit do. The circuit does the following. When we are in state 0, 0 here, and the input is 0, we stay in 0, 0. When the input is 1, we go to state 0, 1. Same thing. When we are in 0, 1, if input is 0, we stay in 0, 1. If input is 1, we go to 1, 0. So what does the circuit do? The circuit, we call it a counter, because it goes through the states 0, 0, and then 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, back to 0, 0, and so forth. And this really completes the part of analyzing sequential circuits.